So hello friends, today we are at my neighborhood. Just beside my house there's a forest. So we are in the forest today and we are going to record some cinematic footages with the mobile phone. So hey friends, welcome. Today we are at this neighborhood near my place, and this is a forest, a small woods near my place, and we are going to record some cinematic footages using a mobile smartphone camera. I am carrying a Manfrotto tripod. It's a handheld tripod, and I'll be recording the whole videos with Galaxy S7. So I'll be mounting the camera on the tripod using a C bracket. So the C bracket goes on the tripod, and then you put your phone on the C bracket. So if you have a tripod attached to your camera, it will stabilize your video much more because it has a weight and it will feel sturdy and it will not be shaking so much. And if you hold it like this, it will behave like a gimbal, a stabilizer, and it will smoothen out most of the camera shakes. So if your camera allows you to shoot at 60 fps, you should turn it on your settings, and it will give you much more cinematic look. To turn on the 60 fps, go to the settings and you can see this full HD 60 fps. If your camera allows you to shoot at 60 fps, select that, or if your camera allows you to shoot more than 60 fps, then you can select 120 fps or whatever your camera allows you to. Having a right camera angle and the frame is very important. Recording something at the eye level is something we are always used to it. So try something different. Try to get your camera close to the ground or very close to an object, or find something which is interesting in the scene and get close to it and try to take an interesting shot out of it. And like I've already said, take more and more shots of different angles and different length, and take as much as you can, because many of them might not end up in the edit like this one, but it's better to have more videos than have little. So we'll get close to this stem. So it has some interesting textures to it. So this is interesting. We'll try to get inside this. So try to take as many shots as possible. So same shot ka aap 4-5 alag alag videos le lo, kyunki kuch na kuch to galat aata hi rahega. So one of those videos will end up in your edit.
So tip number 4 is color grading. Color grading is something which will completely change the look of your shot. It can be a little difficult for somebody who is new to color grading, but once you get used to this, this can be really simple. Also, there are so many LUTs available on the internet which you can download for free. LUTs are like Lightroom presets which you can apply on videos and it will change the look of your shot instantly. And I have included my LUT packs in the download description below, and you can download them and use it for free. Just don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button.
Alright, so now I'll tell you how to quickly apply a LUT to any video in Premiere Pro. First, create an adjustment layer and drag it on top of your videos that you want to apply the LUT on. Then go to the color workspace and go to the right and you'll see Lumetri color tabs. Then in Lumetri colors, go to creative. In creative, go to look, and from look,
browse your favorite LUT that you want to apply on your video. But as soon as you load your LUT, you'll see that it's too much and you want to dial it down from the intensity tab and reduce the intensity to your desired look. And that's it. That is how you apply a LUT in Premiere Pro. Simple as that. So the next step, tip number 5, is editing. Editing will change the way you're presenting your videos. It will dramatically improve the way your video looks in the end. Editing itself is a big topic to discuss in just a few minutes, so I'll probably make a separate video about how to improve your editing. But in this video, I'll give you a few simple tricks in which you can dramatically improve your editing skills. Selecting a good music. Selecting the right music will set the mood of your video. Changing the shots in the beats and in the rhythm and with the tempo will bring sync to your video and the music. So I use my music from Epidemic Sound because it has a huge and amazing library of amazing sound and music, but it's a paid subscription. But if you don't want to spend any kind of money on music, then search on YouTube. You'll get lots and lots of copyright-free music channels which you can use it for free. Black bars on top and the bottom of your video. It instantly creates an illusion that you are shooting the video with a wide-angle anamorphic lens that we usually see in movies. In order to create anamorphic black bars in Premiere Pro, simply create a new adjustment layer and drag the adjustment layer on top of the videos that you want to create the black bars. Go to the effects and search for crop and apply the crop on top of your adjustment layer. Then go to FX control and in crop, put 12% in top and bottom, and that's it. And that is how you simply create anamorphic black bars for your videos. Utilizing your slow motion videos that you've shot with your mobile phone cameras. Changing the videos into slow motion will also create a very smooth and steady shot because it'll also slow down the jerks of your camera. But keep in mind that if you're shooting at 60 FPS, then you can slow down your videos to a maximum of 40% if you're making the video at 24 FPS. But if you shot your videos at 120 FPS, then you can slow down your videos to a maximum of 20% of your actual speed, which is really slow and it creates really cinematic videos. Stabilization. Stabilizing the videos will create very smooth videos like a gimbal. So if you're using Adobe Premiere Pro, then go to Effects and choose Warp Stabilizer and apply it on your video and then click Analyze, and that's it. It'll create smooth and gimbal-like videos for you. Just make sure that you have a nested sequence when you're working with effects or slow motion videos, and then apply the Warp Stabilizer on the nested sequence. So that's it, guys. These are the 5 tips and tricks in which you can improve your mobile phone videography. And if you don't own a DSLR or an expensive camera, then this is how you get amazing results with just your mobile phone cameras. So if you like my video, then please hit the like and subscribe button and support me to make more of these videos so that I can share my experiences of photography and videography with you guys and help you guys learn something new and in the way growing my channel as well. Thank you guys for watching my video and take care, and until next time, see ya.